Man, have I got a good video for y'all today. Looked up, hooked into a 5-pounder. Caught on a jerkbait on windblown point. Biggest fish I've caught in a few years. Caught the majority of my fish at the entrance of the pockets and the creeks and halfway back. There are some shallow way in the back that you can catch them on a lipless. There's not a lot from what I could tell. So the next couple weeks, I'm going to focus on the entrance and halfway back and with a jerkbait. And I mean, you can catch them on a little bit of anything right now, but that's what I'm going to be throwing. I had 15 fish total, and my 5 best was 13.5, almost 13.5. So I might be going tomorrow, which is Sunday. If not, I might be fishing a tournament next Sunday on Cherokee. Hadn't decided yet because I hadn't been doing good at all in the tournaments. But that's the only advice I can give you is the entrance and halfway back of creeks and coves and pockets. If the wind's blowing, throw you a jerk bait. If it's not, throw you a crankbait, shallow, medium diver. The wind was not blowing a lot, but it was like 6 mph, which was just enough to put a ripple on top of it. And it was mostly sunny. There wasn't a lot of clouds, which for most people, they wouldn't throw a jerkbait under those conditions. And I was kind of wondering if it was going to work or not, but it did. So, yeah, that's what I would do if I was you. Throw your jerkbait, especially if the wind's blowing. And if you haven't done it already, please like and subscribe to my channel. And if you don't care, share the video. It'd really help me out. Till next time, tie lines. That's why they're in here. Got all these shad pushed in here. Oh yeah. Man, I like my second cast with that spinnerbait. It's a number 2 in the boat. Gonna have to get bigger.
little, but man, he put up a fight. He took off like a dang 4-pounder. It's number 3 in the boat. Another smallmouth that lost was bigger than that one. Not much, y'all. Stick him in the live well. He needs a picture. Number 5. Number 5, caught him on that little DT6. Starting to get bigger. my biggest one of the day right there. Big, got 2.5, 2.75. We'll find out. An old Vision 110 working. I can just keep them hooked up. So I found this fish this morning floating on top of the water. Looked like it'd been here all night. Put it in the live well, hoping to revive it. Put some of those weights on it that I made. Let's see if it swims off. Nope. It ain't gonna do it. Think it's been in there for 5 hours almost. If it was gonna survive, it'd do it. I think it's number 9 or 10, I can't remember. Jerkbait again. It's number 8, mixed it up, went shallow, got hot, caught a lipless. It's a red eye shad. Thank you. that's number 12. 11 or 12. On that red eye shad. Chrome sexy shad. Jerkbait strikes again. We're on that same point. Oh my God. That might be a 5-pounder. This is a big one. Oh my God. That's the biggest fish I've hooked in a long time. Come on. Sweet Jesus, come on. Come on, big girl. Oh, man. Golly, that might be my PB. Oh, my God. Look at that. That is a beautiful fish. Jerkbait. Oh my God, let's get it weighed and see what it says. 535. Well, he ain't no 5-pounder, but he's still fun. There's the first one. Number two. Number three. I think this one was my second biggest one. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, not sure if you can see it or not, but total weight 1327. Those are my weights right there. Hopefully it's showing up. There we go. That 5-pound kicker really helped.